Marzane Fitko. Number 6, Karenza Fernandes. Number 7, Trisha Woodruff. Number 9, Lee Sanderson. Number 11, Marisha Fernandes. Number 15, Nicole Eastman. Number 16, Chantal Fernandes. And number 20, Aaliyah Gordon. Our umpires today, Richan Gaskin of Barbados and Karine Alves of France. Please stand for the National Anthem of Canada. And for the anthem of Guyana. Our starting team for Canada, Shannon Pereira, Allison Lee, Keisha O'Neill, Michelle Weber, Angela Lancaster, and Catherine Williams. For Guyana, Alicia Shavir, Gabriella Shavir, Trisha Woodruff, Lee Sanderson, Marisha Fernandes, and Chantal Fernandes. Good luck, ladies.
Ernie Johnson, Guyana. Yeah. And somebody shoved him behind us. Early goal, Guyana, early goal, Guyana. Well, the service has got to be good. How the people, in fact, taking the penalty. Oops, I missed it. Reverse, huh?
Umpire must have felt that the slight error on the call.
A lot of pressure, Guyana, early.
Starting a pretty mature lineup here. Mauricio Fernandes is efficient on defense. Also, Sean Paul Fernandes and Lee Sanders team got the running shoot here up front. Canada's opting to fall off about 40 in the moment. And then we're going to be strong defense. Sam's team back out for Guyana. Interesting. Sanderson's from a family of Guyanese mother and Canadian father.
And some offspring players for Canada?
Yes.
Yeah.
She has a brother who played for Canada for a number of years and just retired and is now the coach of their men's indoor team. Mm-hmm. Oh, Sanderson.
3 minutes gone, no score yet, no attempts. And Guyana's had the majority of the play.
Controlling the ball in their own court, they haven't been very effective at the top of this yet today. No opportunities to play. That's a good ball here.
I think the pass that got Guyana into trouble just now should have been maybe a forward pass instead of going back. Yeah.
Pressing the ball, pressing up into Guyana half. And Lee at the back. Ball goes off the touchline and Guyana comes up. Comes yes, Pereira for Canada, reverse kick, saved by the keeper. Good finish by Canada. Quick hands by Weber, he gets to the ball first. And the shot.
Goalkeeper Shabir was drawn by the first shot.
And His mom felt a bit kindly to the Canadians that were seeing. Rebel was very present.
So we think of the play with Guyana leading 1-0, scored in maybe the fifth minute. Guyana tried to come through the middle. Good bit of work as Guyana builds up on the right side. Poor effort to get it off the wall. Canada going back, but just trying to be safe as they take the pressure off. This might lead to a volley. And in fact, it leads to a Canadian hit, leading by 1-0. Good evening, good afternoon, good night, wherever you are. It could be early morning somewhere else. With Canada Lee down the right side. Stopped momentarily by the left full back, trying to get the stick done. Good run down the right side. And Canada beginning now to get into their offensive act.
That goal seems to have brought some life into Canada, right? They seem a lot more vibrant. Made a few substitutions. Cavallo is now on.
Yeah.
As is Guyana, of course, with their two new strikers there in Terence Fernandes and also Marzano picked out in the middle. Some fresh legs on court for both sides already.
Long corner, square to the left full back. Out to the left side. Guyana tried to work it down to get the back stick across the goal mark. Comes free. Counter attack by Canada. Stopped momentarily by the full back. Good pass. And Guyana can now come forward with a quick pass down the right side. The whistle has gone against Guyana. We're in possession, maybe contact with the feet.
Guyana pressing fairly high up. I guess being a goal down, they would like to try to see if they could create that opportunity at least. Level the scores from early. They've had to come from behind in the two previous games against Guyana, right? And they're here to find themselves in a similar situation.
Hard loss yesterday against Uruguay. Hard loss. 15 seconds to go. It was 3-3. It's 1-0 to Canada. And again, wherever you are, a special hello as this is Guyana to get Canada picking up from the pass and a good run down the right side. Very poor passing on that occasion. Substitute made. Philip will pick up the substitutes as they come on. Canada's made a few. Ball to the right full back. Under some pressure. Using the middle and stopped by Canada Lee. Lee looking to get into the circle. Direct ball there, Philip.
Yes. Free hit outside the corner. I just noticed that Guyana seems to be... seems to have the services of Lerma Leogarden warming up on the bench. She's going to be the kind of player that they would require to be able to make something happen against such a solid Canadian defense. So we were delighted to see that she might be able to make an entry into this game after an injury after the rest of the match.
Yeah, Lord knows fleet of foot.
She's definitely one of the more offensive oriented players that Guyana would need to rely on. And under pressure by the Canadian forwards. Guyana team in a pretty young lineup now. They're all from 3 being under 21 players. It's Pitcow in possession. We also have Chung and Calcutta. They're also under 21 players. Well, they're opting to stay with the maturity of Pitcow and Fernandes in the box.
But a nice run from Canada down the right flank.
Yes, Canada is showing some good constructive hockey. They've been rewarded by that one goal from Remo. Halfway through the first half, it's 1-0 to Canada. Canada almost with the steal. Stopping possession of Guyana in the big defense. Good ball. A bit too much for Chuck. Finding a Canadian run past the state park. What do you mean by land pass? You can see some very results. Oh, and Hamilton almost could have gone up Kudov here, right?
Yes.
Approached by Weber, just missing the long pass in the far post.
Guyana in defense, trying to play it out in their own circle. Ball into the middle. And definitely going up against the boot of the Canadian defender. Looking up, looking to go down the right side. Stop straight away to be taken over. Guyana switching to the left side, but poor pass. That was meant to go down the left flank. Whistle is gone.
Guyana's defense making a few errors in succession. Trying to get a ball out. And being intercepted by a solid Canadian war defender.
Guyana wear a dark blue and a white strip. Canada red shorts, dark tops. Two players going down into battle for the ball. And Guyana looking to get it into the circle. I think there's more injury upcoming for Guyana. Yeah. Is that an old injury or an injury?
No, it's stemmed from just something that happened yesterday in the match. It seems like it's going to be a little bit too early for her to play on it again.
Yeah. You can see the pain in the right hand as if she's saying it's hurting. Just a quick question. If you take an average of attacks, the majority in indoor hockey comes down the right side?
Yes, hockey has traditionally been a right-sided game, but teams nowadays have mastered the left as a result of being forced to attack through that side. Indoor hockey, because of the ball coming flat, it's actually much easier to play the ball with the right side and forth, and therefore there's quite a bit of right-side activity in indoor hockey.
And said that in cricket there's the reverse sweep. The reverse stick is coming in a lot more down the left side in indoor.
The outdoor version is very prevalent, almost to the point where players prefer that side now, right? But indoor hockey is still a bit more difficult to shoot on the reverse than it is on the forehand. But teams often like to feed the ball from the forehand into the players on the left side.
Lee with a direct ball that comes off the Guyanese, and it's going to be a free into the circle eventually, and it's taken just on the edge of the circle. Canada leading by a goal to nil, and the ball comes back to Lee, the major central defender. Nice clever work there by the Canadian right. Goes back to Lee. Lee now looking to go up the right wing. We've been talking about that. That's the favorite side. As Guyana try to work the pressure off. Lee again from the edge of the circle. Whistle is gone.
It's defense there by Fitkow. I think Lee was trying to look for a foot to get that penalty corner.
Yeah.
Fitkow remained flat, resolute in front, blocking the ball with a stick. He blocked the long corner rather than the penalty corner. Lancaster at the back of Canada. She has Lee and Pereira. And there's O'Neill. He's winning the battle against Chantel tonight. Canada gets the free outside the team.
All the way back to Lee. Lee looks up, gets over to the right side. Guyana picks it up nicely. And the ball, well, Guyana with a chance to come down the right side.
Stop the advancement of Pereira. Shot at net. Saved by goalkeeper. This is Pereira. Ball out to Saniston. Saniston Lee. Challenging each other. Lee wins out in the circle with the ball. Goalkeeper Pereira is out to smother the attempt. Wrong corner for Canada. Lee making some more offensive efforts right now for Canada.
Chevert came, but it was above the shoulder and maybe just couldn't get the glove up to parry. Yeah. Difficult ball.
Difficult ball, especially as the previous player had drawn Chevert's attention before slipping it to Lee on the left.
Well, I thank the media of Guyana for supporting this international tournament, and we hope to look forward to more inches and more photographs, left, right and center. Internationally, over 18,000 hits on the streaming, which is maybe fairly high standard. And I think NCN breaking new ground in sport in Guyana, and this can be taken further. This can be taken to football, this can be taken to basketball on a regular basis.
Yes, that's correct. It is streamed the under 16 Caribbean Basketball Championships.
Well, here for that.
And NCN did carry some of those games. And now again, they're carrying to Guyana. I think it's good that they spread the popularity of these sports and expose the general public of Guyana to these games and what their top athletes can do.
Local 2020 cricket finals, only 3 hours, you know. Played it in a day, great programming.
Consumption, Guyana in possession. He plays it out of bounds. Guyana's Marzena Pinto, left back, takes possession of the free
hit. Pinto gets it back. Picked up. Well, attempted pickup.
Attempt by Pinto. Trying to get through a wall of Canadians in the middle of the floor. Here's Guyana in the back again.
Instead of looking for the pass, you could have maybe take the responsibility of the shot. That's the question I put to Philip.
Yes, I think that Fernandes was a little bit hasty in the pass. There were several options to be able to hurry quickly to the direct shot.
Yep.
And she opted to get rid of it a bit too quickly there.
But back to Lee, she plays a central part in starting the attacks.
Yes, I think Captain Lee is key in organizing the Canadian attack. You can see her as a very influential player. Seems like there's a penalty stroke for Canada. And Lee herself is going to take it against Shabira. Let's see who will come out on top of this duel.
Well,
not the best of shots, but
no.
I think
She might have been thinking left or right, got caught in a vortex, and it went straight to Chabert, who luckily held a position, didn't choose a corner.
Yes.
So it's still 2-0 with 2:38 left in the first half of Guyana mounting down the right side.
Looking Gabriela to get up in the right corner. He fumbles in a bit. Regains possession. It's going to be a bully. Good composure by the Canadian defense not to commit the foul.
We'll need to be retaken right under our microphones.
Canada wins out on the bully. Here comes Levy. And it's Guyana again. Long ball to Culpepper, intercepted by Lee. Canada settles into defense once again. It's Levy on the attack. And intercepted by Chung. Guyana goes to the forward again to Chabert. So Guyana free hit. Many faces of Woodruff and Fernandes are back in defense for Guyana once again. Interesting ball in.
Very good build up
in Chung. And the foul call and goes to Canada's way. Levy on the attack with the ball and just runs off the baseline.
The last guy in attacking movement with a beautiful interpassing.
Yes, yeah, good for the structure. Good ball up on Woodruff to find that top in the center. Ball with Chabert in midfield, tackled by Carvalho. Now it's Fernandes, up to Culpepper, missed trap. Lancaster in possession, coming the other way. And Captain Lee in possession.
Slows it down, comes back to her fellow fullback. Trying to get it up the right side.
The long corner for Canada after the touch by Woodruff. 9 seconds in the game.
Yep.
Canada be looking for something on this offensive corner, perhaps.
Chabert breaks away.
Chabert breaks away. And it's Canada's ball, the time will expire. So, we tournament favorites Canada take a 2-0 lead into the half. And Guyana must now muster some impetus to try to bring back level those scores in the second.
Yeah, really need a very early second half goal to stay within touch. Let's look at the rest of the program for the afternoon. We have thousands of Guyanese watching on NCN, and I'm sure they would like to wrap up work. Tomorrow, holiday, we hope to have a record crowd at a national holiday for Diwali. And I think there were two interesting matches. Trinidad will be on this afternoon. Barbados will be on this afternoon. Philip Fernandes just drawing up the fixtures. Philip, what have we can offer?
Well, we have Canada and Barbados men playing next after this game. And in terms of ranking, that seems like Canada should have the edge in that match. But Barbados has shown that they can play in Doha quite well, almost defeating Guyana in their opening fixture. And so we expect them to try to make a challenge against Canada. And then we have Argentina and Trinidad women. And that is a must-win game for Trinidad. Although Argentina has shown that they certainly have the quality we've come to expect with the familiar blue and white. And then it seesaws back and forth. It goes back to the men with Guyana versus Trinidad, followed by Uruguay women versus the USA. And then we close off the day with a Mexican-Argentine men's match finale.
That should be a great curtain to come down game. But the game between Guyana men and Trinidad men, Trinidad, you must be feeling every bit of confidence, because last night they really beat the Argentinians convincingly.
Trinidad put on a spectacular performance. performance last night. I thought that they must be very pleased with that. Trinidad is a well-known indoor hockey nation in the Caribbean, and yesterday they've shown that they have the quality to compete with any. I think that it'll be a very exciting, they're an exciting team to watch.
And that the Guns had an outstanding match.
Yes, the Guns were solid, but there's also several other players that they were noticeable. Akeem Toussaint, a diminutive character, but with explosive speed, always a good player to watch.
Okay, we'll take a short break and come back and pick up the second half between Canada leading Guyana 2-0. Gotta look for a knuckle.
And umpire from Barbados, who seems to have reversed the call, due to a bully. So it's gonna be a bully for both teams. Canada wins possession of the ball. Just Pereira, back to Lancaster. Solid in possession, ball into the lead, unable to handle it.
Good look if Guyana comes away with it. Master Fernandes in deep defense. Lays it out. Double steals. Canada regains possession. Guerrero once again. Facing some pressure from the Guyanese forward. Out to Lee, over to Lampard. They're trying to find ways through the right defense of Guyana. Lampard still takes a quick free hit. The penalty corner. Off of Guyana's Marcelino Fiscal.
Good confidence start by Canada in the resumption.
Yes, Canada's pressing high up on Guyana. It's making some dividends for them. Here.
Service from the left side. What's the options?
Lee's going to take it direct. This is the goal. Shabir seems to have had it covered.
Yeah, she certainly and then pulled out of the coverage. It made contact. Guyana need to score quickly to get back into still 2-0. The 3 minutes gone of the second half. Ball down the right side, but wayward right side. And the Canada's got the ability to keep the ball, build the passes, but Guyana not producing that.
That's correct. Canada seeming to be more competent. It seems like a penalty corner is called for Canada.
Interesting after the last attempt, whether Lee makes a direct shot again.
Yep.
Shot forward.
Guyana don't feel it. Guyana don't feel they're getting the rubber to green with the whistles.
I rather suspect they made up for the bump to the striker on the left leg, given what happened.
No, they don't change it.
And he goes straight directly as well. Saved by Shabir.
Yeah. High to the left hand.
Long corner for Canada.
Lee to take it. Looks up. Looks for the square ball, no surprising. Back to Lee. Out to the left side, comes across, heads for the circle. Nice bit of stick work. Nicely tackled by Pidcock.
Guerrero on the top. Canada. Fresh legs on the court in the top for Guyana. Fernandes summoning Shabir. The ball is through to Lancaster with Shabir putting the playing pressure. This summoning Shabir across the court. Try to force the interception. The main competitor comes in with it. And there's a whistle guard.
The way how Shabir is built, it's pretty hard to get her off the ball.
Yes.
You know, center of gravity and all that.
Yes. These girls are, of course, doing a lot of physical training with, a lot of weight training, strengthening. The modern sports, as you know, requires a lot of physical attributes.
A little bit of sportsmanship by Shabir, going to check on Lee. Lee is up and not done for the count. Right across to the left side. Three Guyanese in ascendance there. Ball passed back to the end of the circle. One by Lee. Lee is all over the court. Shot in. Nicely.
Second shot comes in. From Guyana's table. Out to Fernandes. Fernandes under the pressure by Leahy. Guyana controlling the ball in defense.
Lee of Canada in the last attack got far up the court.
Yes. Good aggressive attack in Fernandes.
Yeah. 14 minutes left on the clock. Guyana need to pull one back very soon. for us since goodnight Irene in terms of qualifying.
Nice ball in the finals. So I should be able to come to you. Oh. That's good, my dear. He was just going for a couple of Canadian defenders. He seems to have taken a tumble once again. Guyana wins a penalty corner.
Chabert reminds me of a footballer, and I can't remember the name, who really troubles defense because of her weight and her aggression. Well, so far maybe not the ideal result Guyana wanted overall, but they have been disgraced.
Yes, they've been playing a good competitive match. Canada is a very, very quality side. I think Guyana, if they can pull one back with this penalty corner, will be heading into the final 10 minutes in a fairly decent position.
Where did it go to feed cow?
Woodruff lines up for the first strike. Over to Fanal. Ball hits the post. Williams called.
Lady luck not in Guyana's side.
Yeah. Yeah, get another chance.
Yeah. That would have been a welcome goal at this point. So they start all over again. Will they change it?
Same with here. This time it's fouled by goalkeeper. Canadian goalkeeper.
Yes, they're on a roll. Can they take advantage? Will they take advantage? Canada under pressure. The pressure's being felt by the Canadians. 12 minutes and 4 seconds left in the half. And Guyana really need to pull one back. She was in a wonderful position.
Yes, there's a chance that they can get a 4-0. It's going to be a 1-minute timeout.
Canadian bench or Guyana bench?
I'm not sure who to call the timeout. Yep. I would assume maybe Guyana, given the fact that they're down 2 goals and just 11.5 minutes remaining.
Or Canada, because they've been under such pressure in the last 3 minutes. Nice crowd building up, and potentially we want to see the evening session well attended. Don't forget that tomorrow is a national holiday, and we know that there are Diwali events, but please spare a thought for the Hockey Association and the event, the Pan American Playoff, and all the international sides here. One of the biggest sporting events ever to be held in Guyana. And no doubt it enhances Guyana's name internationally, because the world body just take into consideration hosting and attending.
Gets a shot off, hits the foot of the wheel.
Another indecision there. Nice change. Lovely change. Lee and Levy make a very good pair.
Oh yes, yes, yes. Except for your country.
Exactly 10 minutes left in the half. Guyana building a lot of pressure in the last 5 minutes. Now winning the ball and coming forward. The whistle is gone. Guyana in possession. Down to Pico. Yep. Interception by Canada, but the ball going on to the feet. Reverse pass out to the left side. The guy in the captain playing it square, getting it to Fitkow. Fitkow down the right side. Momentarily lost by Guyana. Whistle has gone in their favor. Back, tried to open it up. Trying to spread it around left side. Inside, chance for the shot.
That is to Eastman. Good opportunity there. Being a bit of a break there, Eastman. Indoor hockey is a game that you need to be very low to the floor.
And feed the part.
Very well balanced. It's one interception. When she comes to Guyana here, and misses the first time shot. I think Guyana can ill afford opportunities against
the
side like Canada.
And it didn't have pressure. Nobody was on her.
All of the fifth ball now. We've been having a good game for Guyana. Except for that moment, which passes the ball on the touch. Guyana applying a bit more aggressive pressure at the top now. Fernandes going hard at me. Eastman of Lancaster. So I'm going to leave him some space enough for Cavallo to have a running goal. Fast to Leahy, just missing out.
Good defensive work by Fitko.
Sanderson possession. After Wulu. Good goal score. Fernandes cuts off into the right side of the knee. Lost the control of the ball. Off the back of Canada. I think, friends, you can see the quality in the quality difference in the two sides when we're looking at the forced errors being created by the Guyanese players.
Yeah.
The Canadians. I think Guyana squandered too many easy chances and easy possessions, and that has costed them too far to score line. A save there by Javier, coming away with his sister Gabriel on the right side, right over the surface, good possession. Guyana's I would think 5th or 6th penalty corner by now. A strong run by Shaquille.
Brilliant is the individual run. Running from deep in her own half.
Yeah. Which is what Guyana can produce.
They need to get a clean shot. Well, this quartet has probably worked in practice, and they stick with the quartet.
Good call, shot saved on the line by the Canadian defender. Looks like it was Lee. He was showing her multi-dimensional effect for Team Canada in this match.
Just 6 minutes left on the clock.
Canada now pressing high against the Guyanese defense. First of Fernandes in possession. Good ball for Chavez, who seemed unexpected. And losing the opportunity. Sanderson comes delivering for Guyana. Captain possession, but she wins out on the second tackle. Ball goes to Paranoi. Lancaster and Canada driving up in the left back position. Tackled by Shabir. This ball goes to Lee of Canada at the back. Finding Fadan from the defense. Fadan got the same question by O'Neill. Out to Sanderson. Here to Guyana. Fadan finds a space for the Canadian defense, but no Guyanese present.
Some fresh legs brought in.
Guyana's, I'm not too sure if any of the legs are still fresh at this point.
Yeah,
the legs up the legs. Reconditioned legs.
Rested legs.
Well, the demand, a rescue pass across the big
one. Yeah.
Guyana giving up a penalty corner on a forced error in defense.
And overall, there have been too many back passes deep into the circle, which puts a lot of pressure on the receiver. So just over 4 minutes left, with Canada leading 2-0. Not a bad performance overall, scoreboard size. But if you watch the game, Guyana was good enough to at least have scored one goal from the many opportunities.
We're about to observe the next story, the next chapter in the story of Lee versus Shabir. Ball out. He passes this one out. Saved on the line by Marissa Finance. Out to Carenza Finance. Gives it to Shabir. Seems like the umpire is calling. What is this? Canada.
Some discussion by the Guyanese about the decision.
Yeah, it seems like the Guyanese defender was indicating it was saved with a stick.
Yeah.
Seemed that way to me, to be honest, Fred, but of course the umpires have a much better vantage point than he did. And he misses on that occasion. So Shabir keeps her clean sheet with respect to penalty strokes.
And she was moving right in the right corner too.
Yes, she was.
Some complaints. I'm staying at the Howe Hotel where there are coaches and they're talking about the lack of consistency in the calls. Some calls are not as consistent as others. Of course, coaches will be very sensitive.
As often said by coaches.
Yeah.
Of course, we have umpires from all over the Americas and neutrals from elsewhere in the world. And then we have teams from all over the Americas.
What?
We have different styles of hockey and so on. So there are some slight inconsistencies in terms of interpretation and rules occasionally.
What's the situation with Guyanese officials? Are any getting up to the time when they will be able to get their license or their qualifications?
We do have one Guyanese in the tournament officiating, Devin Hooper, in the men's tournament. We have a Guyanese judge, Dominique Groff, doing her first tournament this time around. We are making every effort to try to see if we can get more young people in that direction to develop them, because that raises, of course, the quality of the game as well. So we see an interesting tactic by Guyana. They have full goalkeeper Shabir. They've opted for a sixth field player. But an unfortunate error by Woodruff. In their pass to Finance, gives Canada possession at the half line. So Guyana without the goalkeeper at the moment. Opting for all out the top. 6 field players. They must keep Canada out of their scoring circle in this situation, Reds, because any shot at goal can go
That goes in favor of Canada with no more people left. Fernandes goes down bravely, saving the first shot with her throwing her body in the bottom of the first shot. Ball now out to Leahy. He's looking for O'Neill. Turns, attacks to Dean. Leahy stuck the handle up in the right hand corner. Guyana comes to win the possession again. And it's two goals to come, a bit. It's Guyana, right? Leaving Guyana, needing a goal a minute.
Yeah, a brave decision by the Guyana bench to take out Chavere. Yeah.
Brave indeed, but maybe a bit too late even. Lancaster. Seemed to pop the ball up. The umpire judged it to be a third party obstruction by the Guyana. Guyana on full press now. Trying to see if they can force that much needed turnover by Canada. Long ball was wasted. Guyana in possession. Coming forward. 1 minute left on the clock. And ball from Fernandes to Fernandes. Drives up the left. Looking for Sanders. And finally goes in the Canada's direction. And Lee settles the ball.
And Lee's going to slow it down, I'm sure.
Sanderson in possession, battling against Pereira. Ball goes Canada's way. Lee here on the ball. Leaves it to Lee. Ball almost intercepted by Big Ball. Back to Canada again. Clock running down inside a minute. Here comes Woodruff. Wins out the battle against O'Neill. Woodruff makes a long pass. O'Neill blocks. Allows it to play on. Here comes Canal. Tries for the long ball with the lead. Gives Guyana a penalty corner opportunity.
He's seconds away.
Looks like this will be Guyana's last opportunity for the match as time is about to expire. And they can at least salvage some time by putting a goal on the scoreboard.
So the official minutes have run out, Canada leading 2-0, which is just as a good a victory, but it's not over until it's over.
As long as the ball comes 3 yards outside the D-Reds, plenty corners is over. Good call. Try to win a second penalty corner.
Showing a lot of character, guy, and a lot of fight.
Canada has already secured the win, but it's a button of fight at the moment. Whether Guyana can actually penetrate what has been in penetrated so far for the game. Big call again, and shot goes wide, and that brings us to the end of the match. Canada pulling off a well-deserved victory against Guyana.
Over the years, what's been the matchup with the Guyana female team and Canada?
In the outdoor version of the game, Reds, Canada has been far superior. The last few times Guyana played Canada, they have beaten in the high single digits, 8-0, 7-0, that sort of score. In the indoor version, they've never played each other. So I think that 2-0 in indoor, which is typically a higher scoring type of version of the game, it's not a bad result for Guyana.
Well, we hope to have the Canadian coach we've invited to come across. If she can remember the invitation by the commentary team, she first of all got to have duties to her own team, but she said she did come for a few minutes. And later, Philip, the good news is that the Trinidad and Tobago coach is going to join us on the commentary.
Yes, we might get to get some insight from those folks and get the perspective of how the teams are finding the tournament and their experiences. With this indoor Pan American Cup here in Guyana.
So already. Trinidad men appearing. And Barbados beginning to assemble also. I hope our Canadian coachman remembers us. It'll be nice to have her for 5 minutes. In the meantime, we hope that you will come on, finish working this afternoon. You'll come and support the hockey. It's only $500. You know, you mightn't have had a chance to check with your treasurer. Reasonable taking on the opening day?
Yes, I think we had a fairly sizable crowd.
I think there's a good atmosphere in the venue. I think we're expecting a similar result this evening and then certainly tomorrow when it's holiday.
Yes, starting time for those listening for tomorrow. Just trying to provide information for you in the meantime.
Tomorrow's matches start at 2 o'clock with a ladies' battle between Canada and Trinidad and Tobago.
Well, you have time to attend your Diwali festivals and your Diwali ceremonies. And here you are. Hope you will come on and give us almost a sellout crowd on this national holiday tomorrow. I want to say an appeal to all the cricketers, all the footballers, all the basketball players. You have a commitment to support the Guyana Hockey Federation. All the senior officials, not just the players, please come and support your own fellow associations, as you will hope that hockey will support you when you've got your tournament on. While we take a break, Philip, if the Canadian coach comes, we'll soon get her on.